Checklists are used to evaluate the candidate's performance. But instead of on paper, they are now on your iPad. Chapter 1. Before the exam. At the examination station, you will find an iPad that contains all of the checklists you will need for this examination day. Open OSCE Eval. This is the rotation overview. The checklists are grouped by rotation and are represented as stacks. Tap on the stack corresponding to your next OSCE rotation. This is the checklist for your first candidate. Checklists don't usually fit on an iPad screen. Swipe up and down to see all the items of the checklist. Swipe from left to right to see the order of all candidates at your station. The top left arrow gets you back to the rotation overview. Chapter 2. During a rotation. First, you need to identify the candidate by looking at their badge. Make sure that the candidate's name matches the one displayed on your checklist. To evaluate the candidate's performance, you must fill in the checklist. To do so, tap the buttons on the checklist and choose one of the available options. You may change your evaluation by tapping the button again and picking another option. Your evaluation of a candidate is complete once you have provided an answer for each item on the checklist. This icon displays how many items you still have to answer. Tapping the icon shows you only the items that you still need to answer. Tapping it again returns you to the full checklist. Some checklist items require a number of sub-criteria to be fulfilled by the candidate. Tapping these criteria will help you remember which of them the candidate has fulfilled. Like with paper checklists, you may also add your own notes. This is especially encouraged if something out of the ordinary happens. You may also start a timer. This is useful in situations where you need to remind the candidate that half of their time has passed. The timer will only sound if your iPad has not been muted. After the candidate has left your station, you will usually have a couple of minutes to finish your evaluation before the next candidate shows up. Choose the next candidate from the list no later than when they enter the room. Please remember to verify the candidate's name on your checklist and continue as you did before. Chapter 3. After a rotation. Once you have evaluated all candidates of a rotation, you should finalize it. To do so, tap the Sign button in the candidates list. Sign with your finger to finalize the rotation. This means that no further changes can be made to your evaluations. To continue evaluating candidates of a different rotation, choose the rotation in the rotation overview. Chapter 4. Special cases. In very rare situations, candidates might not appear in the correct order. Usually they are lost or ought to take a break. But if you are sure that a mix-up has occurred, just select the correct candidate from your list and start entering your evaluations. In In even rarer cases, candidates might not show up for the exam at all. In this case, you should denote the absence. Swipe your finger over the candidate's name and tap the red button. Should the candidate reappear at a later stage, you can reverse this easily.